he'll get his opponent on the ledge, and he'll he won't be on the ledge. He'll be a little bit of ways away in stage, but his back will be turned, right? And he'll just sit there and wait. And then he takes the smallest step, and then the opponent gets off the ledge. He just like baits him out and he just kills him immediately. I'm just like, what is this?
He does that so much, man. You have no idea how many times he does. But now I want to see how to do it. Elman's actually opting for a Pyro in the early matchups against against Mega Man, which I'm surprised about. Because usually we're just so used to seeing Mythra. And when I want to watch this matchup, god damn it, Nintendo, we're not gonna watch the matchup.
You did say usually, and I thought that was pretty funny.
Yeah, usually.
Yeah, you is usually.
And usually we don't get these damn disconnects. Yeah. We'll get more disconnects, Skiff.
It is unfortunate, but you know what? Maybe Nintendo's, maybe they dropped the mid-match patch they don't want us to see quite yet. They're letting these players test it right now. Some privileged gameplay going on. I'm not sure that either of these players stream. So I'm not sure if we could actually go... Well, let me double check here.
All right. Well, Skiff goes and double checks. We're gonna be enjoying Twitch chat right now. Megaman's a cool character. Pyromyth is a cool character. Never actually played. You know, I never really played. What game Pyromyth are from again? I completely forgot.
Xenoblade Chronicles.
Xenoblade. Too. That's right. Never really played Xenoblade Chronicles. The first one or the second one. So.
Neither have I.
Yeah. But. They are. They do look super sick in this game, which I really appreciate.
You is not streaming. They do stream, but they're not streaming today. And the other one just doesn't have a stream that brings it to a Twitch connected to their PG stats that brings them to, you know, at least something we can watch. So we'll just have to sit here and wait and see how this plays out. You did point out how they were starting off Pyra, and I think Pyra honestly just has like so much crazy damage and knockback and disjoints and go way out there.
Like, yeah,
it's the character's insane. But I would imagine that probably starts off here, and then maybe Elman at some point goes, okay, I kind of can't dance around all these projectiles and pressure that Mega Man can put out. Maybe switches to Mythra at that point.
Maybe. Maybe you just have to adapt to the way Mega Man wants to play. I think the biggest thing when you look at how people start piloting these two characters is, you know, just the ability to switch, man. The ability to just mix up the when you want to switch. Mm-hmm. So I think it's going to be the biggest point thing, because even though the flowchart is always saying, yo, Mythra works real good at low percent because you can combo him. And then, of course, Pyra is when you want to use him to kill, around 60, 70, 80, 100, et cetera, et cetera. Mixing up when you want to swap and mixing up the way you want to approach from both these two characters is probably the best way you want to optimize them, regardless of percent, because they do... Pyro does a lot of damage. If you get one good hit, that's basically, you know, one of Mythra's combos already. Mm-hmm. You know, and vice versa, where Mythra can just outframe and set up Pyro. So that's one thing I want to see.
It definitely is interesting, especially with like that one setup that Pyro has, that down air, that the spike hitbox on that thing is humongous.
So
and
big, man.
It's huge. And when you land it on someone on the ground, it just sets right up for that, you know, up tilt, up smash. Up special, and all of them will kill. Like, so I mean, there's definitely some pretty cool tools, and also that what's the side special called? I forgot what her side special called. The one that she throws
Blazing End.
Blazing End. That move is insane. I'm not sure how good it's going to be offline, because like it might be a bit more reactable, but like I know for sure it's a great pressure tool. Unless your opponent's like super ready for it, like they're not gonna be able to punish you for it. It's actually really, really insane how that move just kind of goes out there. But you're right, man. If you can find a way to switch it up between the two often, and they switch quick too. Like
they
this
switch
is
quick.
Like, this is not like Zelda Sheik switching. Like they switch immediately. Yeah. It could be lethal. But we're gonna see you take that game one. I'd really like to see how L-Man played to be, you know, to say like, oh, I guess I could expect that, or oh, I couldn't expect. Because if it was all Pyra, I'm not too surprised.
Oh, yeah. That's what I was wondering, you know. Like, and also, again, it depends on the way Mega Man plays, and if you is a balanced Mega Man, that means you have to utilize both at a pretty high level. You have to use Pyra and Mythra at the same time at a pretty good level, man. Because if you realize you is playing campy, it's very obvious that Mythra is just better in those situations. If you know that you want to try and rush down with the dash attacks and hit with the approaching lemons, then you just go Pyra and you just try and whack him away. But hopefully we don't get this. I swear to God, man. I'm jinxing this. We ain't jinxing this today.
Yeah, I'd love to watch some Yu. Yu's actually super, super fun. L-Man's also a great player, but like, we don't see enough Mega Man. Like, yeah. this character is absolutely insane.
Y'all don't. I see it all the time.
Yeah, you see it all the time. Yeah, Minnesota just kind of built a little different on that end.
Minnesota's built different. But smaller stage, we're going to Smashville. Elman did take this.
Ooh.
All right.
Okay, so if that's some of the stuff that we probably missed, I guess I can see why was probably putting the work on the Pyra here. That was definitely a lot of damage. And Pyra, not necessarily heavy, but she's a little taller and she's very slow. So I guess I'm not surprised with some of this pressure. Oh,
he's sticking to Pyra this entire time too, by the way. That's what's crazy to me. He hasn't opted for a swap. He hasn't gone for anything. I'm trying to use prominence to get back on stage, but you're a little slow, man. I think he's using so many Blazing Ends in just the early stages. It hasn't gone for anything so far, man. Using it again.
Man, this pressure so far. Here's the thing. Yeah, now that they're 67%, they're 67%, right? They just need to land one good hit and you're dead. True. Like, that's just that easy. Oh, they could have had it right there.
But remember, man, the reason why you make a swap is because you change up the way you perceive everything. But, Blazing Nova does a lot, especially when it covers a lot of options. Of course, not going to kill, though, but you get me Blazing End right in front of his face, bro. Flame Nova to try and mix up the way he comes back approaching it.
Yeah, that was actually a really great air dodge and using that Blazing End to just kind of cover the ledge, allowing them to just air dodge right there. Not have to worry about getting caught up in any some crazy stuff. But this is starting to get very interesting. Gonna just get clipped by that forward smash ending that stock. All right.
Remember, man, Elman hasn't gone for swaps at all. Like, he doesn't want to play Mithra at all, man. Even though this stage is smaller, even though you can go for a lot more combos, promise Ramon is going to get shielded up. Mm-hmm. But Elman needs to swap, man. The more you stay on Pyra, the more the player's just going to adapt to the way you want to move and the way you want to approach, and just the move speed of the character. But when you make a swap, you now you just swap to a fast character, more frame data. You get the trade here, but then if it's a lot, if like what you said, Skiff, Elman just stayed on Pyra the entire time, it looks like he is. We're not going to see a swap. I think you might just be looking to take because he's going to be able to adapt this match real soon.
Yeah, I mean, who knows? Maybe they're getting the adaptation right now. I mean, they're trading percentages back and forth here, so the Pyra's not looking too bad. I think it looks awful because Yu just kind of goes off for, like, these crazy combos, and then Elman's only getting a couple hits, but, like, those couple hits are, like, evening it up. So maybe that's just we're just kind of getting caught up in some of the Mega Man madness.
Yeah.
But right now, it is looking a little tough here, but, I mean, looks are deceiving. Elman's hanging in here pretty well.
I think it's because Yu's just going way too up close to personal sometimes. I think if Yu just played campy like he did that first stock, it would be working wonders. Oh, sure, you can.
Okay, there we go. Oh, gotta get the shield poke with that back air. That thing's got like 3 or 4 hitboxes or something like that, and it's absolutely lethal.
Yeah, the tornado also just damages the shield so heavily when you're sitting on top of the platform, man. Hurts a lot when you're stuck sitting on that shield.
Okay, Elman has gone for that twice now. Has hit it one time and almost took a stock, but that move has a lot of shield damage as well.
And along with that, it has a lot of. It actually ends pretty fast. Like, you think you can punish it, but sometimes in situations you're like, what? I can't punish that move?
Yeah, it looks like it's gonna be laggy.
It looks mad like, but nope, not a situation, but. Still, Elman's still sticking with the Pyra. Hasn't opted for the swap. Just trying to see if he can land any big hit. Remember, moves are a little bit slower.
Ooh. Oh, he probably could have gone off stage a bit more and just kind of got a couple more tips with that leaf shield. And even if he lost the stock, like, Elman wasn't going to be making it back. Great Blazing End.
All these moves are getting stale. The more you're staying in Pyra, the more you're going to be throwing the same moves.
Oh.
Up till finally going to kill.
Yeah, I was like, oh, Mega Man's so fine, and then absolutely wasn't.
All right.
Let's see. Both of them will be dancing around here. Elman does have to be careful. They're looking at loser's bracket.
Man.
Should they drop this? That's it.
Good stuff, man. That's what I'm saying, man. If you're you and you stick around to Pyra, you're going to just adapt to this move speed to everything of what Pyra wants to throw out, whereas Mithra plays an entirely different game. And I think that if Elman just swapped... Just threw some Mithra in there, I know you set up the Pyra, but just sprinkle a little bit of that Mithra in there. Mm-hmm. I think it changes up the entire game plan because you're able to rush down, you're able to pressure, you're able to just retreat, swap back, throw Blazing in, and then rush down Photon Edge. A lot of things you could do with the flow chart of Mithra and Pyra, but fortunately, Elman's gonna fall down. He's gonna advance onwards to the bracket.
Yeah, I mean, definitely rough. I do gotta hand it to him for just kind of sticking it out, but. Mm-hmm. yeah, that was definitely a little bit tough. It was fairly even for the most part, but like once it got to like the home stretch, like you just kind of really took over. What pretty crazy.
Yeah. I remember, man, like you. That the reason why the game went close because you was like, yo, let me just try and box you real quick. Let me just get you up close and personal. He's like, that's not how it works, man. Just stay back and shoot them lemons, and then you'll win. You know, once you start playing camping against Pyra, it works a lot of wonders, and I think you definitely made that work. But we'll see if Elmat can stay into the game. He's going to be hopping down to the loser side, but and he still has a life, but some life coming in. But I got to see some swaps, bro. You play two characters. You got to make sure you're using two characters.
Whoa, actually, hey, I'm looking at some stuff right here, and we got an upset alert.
Oh,
ding, ding. Like, we actually just had Johnny. Now, it's not to say, I'm not saying Johnny's a bad character, but Johnny 2-1 to Wadi. Oh, wait, Wadi was playing Ridley. Interesting. You know what? That's still an upset, right, man. Wadi's a fantastic player.
It's still an upset, but we also have to be mindful that Wadi plays whatever he wants, man. When you meet Wadi, you know Wadi. Wadi's like, I'm gonna do my thing. I'm gonna just have fun. Sometimes there's nights where he wants to have fun. Sometimes there's nights where he wants to try new things out. Maybe this night's Wadi, not to dismiss Johnny from winning, but Wadi playing. He never played really. He never played really. But he won't play really tonight. And I'm like, all right, cool. Do your thing. So
I mean, it's Wadi, man. He's number 20 in the world offline. Yeah. Has been killing it online. Honestly, he can play any character. He's got fantastic fundamentals. But I was actually taking a look. The reason why I was looking at that, so I was trying to see where Elman was going to be in the loser side of bracket. They're going to be basically taking on a few players. Like Johnny is going to be in that path, but Johnny's going to get past Jake. And also on that side, we got people like Hot Dog Knight and Professor MGW who could also pose a problem. But I think Jake is going to be a real big issue for Elman. So hopefully Elman's going to.